video, which is part two, we'll be cutting the screw thread on the blanks that we made in part one. The screw thread is a left-hand thread, imperial, and the lathe is metric. So I'll show you how to set up the lathe to cut imperial threads, and we'll finish off these chuck jaw screws so I can get the four jaw chuck working again.
As you see, this one is just broken away. For cutting an 8 teeth per inch on a 3mm lead screw, I need three gears, a 36 tooth gear, which is that one, and this holder I made, I've got the actual numbers on them so I can see what's missing, and a 32 tooth gear, which is this one. They are the standard gears. To convert from metric to imperial, I also need this one, which is a 135 tooth gear with 127 tooth gear combined. This is a setup for the gear wheels. We've got a 36 on there, 32 on the lead screw, and this is a conversion gear. ½ degree angle, flat top, because it's a form tool. You don't put a rake on the top, otherwise you'll lose the form shape. I'm just setting the tool at centre height. First of all, set my clock to zero. Get the tool up. Till it just starts to move, and I know that's at centre height. So I've just checked that my tool's square by placing a square on the job and bringing it into the tool. Just checking that it's square with the job. Just touched the tool onto the job and zeroed my cross slide, so I know I can start there. I've measured on this one the diameter on the outside, which I've already reproduced on this, and I've measured the distance between the bottom of the threads, and I've calculated that I need to go 65 thou deep to form that thread. And because it's a left hand thread, we start cutting this end and go across. I need to slow the speed down and engage the thread cutting. So I've marked up the part with blue so I can see where it's cutting. I'm going to take a trial cut just to check that the number of teeth match up with the part. Matches. So now I've engaged the lead screw, I can't disengage it, so I have to back the tool off, reverse the lathe, just check that it is okay, that's the jaw. As you can see, that fits in the thread. Not quite deep enough yet, so I've got to go another 0.2. Now that should be down to depth. So let's try it on the jaw. If I compare that, speed it up, emery over the top of that, get a nice smooth finish because it's thrown up a burr on all the edges, and turn it round and do exactly the same on the other end. Okay, I've turned it round. Before I start cutting the thread, I'm just checking the run out, it's within a couple of thou, which is okay for that. Start cutting the next thread. The next job is to part this off and then face the ends to length. Okay, I just saw that little bit off. Some more to come off that. Through 133. That's finished. (laughs) 2.133, so I'll just put a chamfer on that one. That one done. 135, that's okay. So there we've got 4 chuck jaw screws. There's the original. Always hexagons on the end. And I can reassemble the chuck. So check in there that it will fit the chuck by sliding there, which it does. Next job is to put the pin back in the back. These pins here hold the chuck jaw central. Okay, let's come back in. Put the screw back in that holds it. WD-40. There we go. This chuck has now got 2 jaw. That's an original. That's an original. That's the one we've just made, and that's the one I made before. So now just put it back on the plate. We're ready to go. There we go. one four-jaw chuck repaired, ready for action. Well, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope to see you next time on Enots Engineering.